KTSA NewsFlash.
Federal prosecutors say a sporting goods retailer violated the law by selling an AR-15 style rifle and large capacity magazine to a man who used them to kill more than two dozen worshipers at a Sutherland Springs church in 2017. The Department of Justice said Tuesday in a San Antonio court filing that Devin Kelly presented a Colorado driver's license at an Academy Sports and Outdoor store in Texas to buy the rifle and ammunition. Prosecutors say federal law requires Academy to comply with Colorado statutes that would have prohibited the sale. Academy declined comment today. Prosecutors want to add Academy as a responsible third party in an ongoing lawsuit. President Donald Trump comes to Texas today to cut the ribbon on a Louis Vuitton workshop and to meet with donors to his campaign.
Even the Dallas Mavericks, who play their home games at the American Airlines Center, can't generate the kind of enthusiasm that a presidential visit can.
I just went straight to Walmart. I bought the things I thought I would need to sleep out here overnight.
As President Trump rallies his backers here, Beto O'Rourke, who'd like to replace him in the White House, will hold an event for his supporters a few miles away, telling them on Twitter,
"This is our opportunity to stand up against Donald Trump, who's going to be..."
If the idea of dueling Trump-O'Rourke rallies sounds familiar, maybe it's because the same thing happened in El Paso in February. Jim Ryan, ABC News, Dallas.
The San Antonio City Council is scheduled to vote on a $205,000 settlement for a woman who claims a police officer went too far with a cavity search.
Natalie Sims claims she was sitting near a street in 2016 talking on her cell phone when she was approached by police. They searched her car for drugs and then called Detective Mara Wilson to the scene. Sims claims she was standing with her hands in the air when Wilson performed a vaginal cavity search and pulled out her tampon as male officers were nearby. After failing to find drugs, Sims was allowed to drive away. City Council today will vote on a $205,000 settlement. Elizabeth Ruiz, KTSA News.
There's a lot at stake in the 2020 census.
The census is critically important because it provides information that helps to get adequate representation from Congress and adequate funding from the federal funds that come to our community.
San Antonio Census Administrator Berto Rodriguez says the census will begin April 1st. The city of San Antonio has allocated $392,000 for outreach and marketing for it. If you can't beat them, join them. The Vatican has a new smart gadget to capture the attention of young Catholics.
The Vatican has launched a click-to-pray e-rosary to reach young people where they spend most of their time on their smartphones. The rosary is an app-driven bracelet in the shape of a cross with beads that help kids learn how to pray. The e-rosary is activated by making the sign of the cross and is synchronized with a free app, which opens an audio guide with exclusive images and personalized content. The e-rosary is already available online if you're willing to pay to pray, about $100. Megan Williams, ABC News, Rome.
It may be too early for Christmas music and decorations for some people, but Bluebell Ice Cream is already scooping some holiday cheer.
Bluebell bringing back their Christmas cookies ice cream flavor. The sugar cookie flavored ice cream is blended with chocolate chips, snickerdoodle, and sugar cookies. Green icing and red sprinkles also mixed in. So if you need a little bit of Christmas while decorating for Halloween, grab a spoon and dig in. The flavor is available now, but only for a limited time, and Bluebell promises that they've increased production to meet the demand for their popular holiday flavor. Don Morgan, KTSA News.
KTSA Money News.
There's a new Brexit deal. European Union and British leaders have an outline agreement, which still needs the backing of EU member nations. The president of the European Commission tweeted, the deal is, quote, a fair and balanced agreement. Prime Minister Boris Johnson reiterated that sentiment. A green light for T-Mobile and Sprint. Regulators have approved a deal for the two parties to merge. The $26.5 billion agreement is still not at the finish line. It is facing a lawsuit by a group of state attorneys general who say the tie-up will harm consumers. Many Americans are unprepared for a recession. According to a new Bankrate survey, 4 in 10 people are not ready if a recession hits in the next 6 to 12 months. Of those who are preparing, 44% are spending less money, 33% are saving for emergencies, and 31% are paying off credit card debt. And today is National Pasta Day. A slew of chains have deals for the latest food holiday. Olive Garden is bringing back its never-ending pasta bowl for $10.99 until November 24th at Maggiano's. You can get $10 off your meal with an email sign-up. Bertucci's has a 4 for $40 deal. That's four meals with one family-style pasta dish and other fixings. And that's your CBS MoneyWatch.com report. I'm Diane King-Hall.
K-
KTSA AccuWeather.
Partly sunny for the afternoon. The high today at 75. Mainly clear tonight. Low 50 in the hill country. 57 along the Riverwalk. A partly sunny day tomorrow. The high near 84. Partly sunny, warmer Saturday. The high up to 91. I'm Steve Williams with your KTSA Stevens Roofing AccuWeather forecast.
I'm Dennis Foley. Get news around the clock in 550. KTSA FM 107.1. Get news anytime online at KTSA.com.